My name is David, and my supervisors are Benjamin Woods and Stephen Burrow from the University of Bristol. So first, let me give you an introduction about the problem that we want to solve. So most of the aircraft wings have discrete control surface. This type of control surface have a gap or a discontinuity that causes a premature detachment of the boundary layer, leading to an increase of drag and noise. So one way to solve this problem is using morphing structures. Morphing is inspired by nature, especially flying animals. So these type of animals, they have soft and elastic wings, and they don't have any discontinuity along the wing. So that favors for a small transition in the flow. At this moment, we are working with a morphing device that is called the FishBAC. The FishBAC is inspired in the fish's skeleton and is flexible as avian wings. However, avian wings has the ability to switch stiffness. For example, when they require to sustain aerodynamic loads, the wing has to be strong and stiff, so they contract their muscles. So for other flying conditions, when they require to be soft and elastic, they relax the muscles. So at this moment, we are working with an active material that can switch stiffness. This active material works with the principle of granular jamming. So granular jamming, it's granular media that when it's combined and compressed in all directions, there is an increase of contacts among particles. So the more the contact of particles, the material behaves more like a solid, so it's quite stiff. And vice versa, when the less the shear stress, the material behaves like a fluid. We are controlling this variation of stiffness by using vacuum. So as you can see in the right bottom picture, it's a beam that is filled with granular media inside an elastic membrane and connected to a vacuum hose. When vacuum appears, it compresses the media in all directions, so it's quite stiff and strong, as you can see. At the moment when we remove the vacuum, the beam collapses because it behaves like a liquid. So our main goal is to combine the flexibility of the FishBAC using the variation of stiffness of granular jamming in order to create a new morphing device that is called the SwitchBAC. So as you can see in the bottom pictures, the SwitchBAC was 3D printed and filled with coffee grains. We choose that material because it's stiffer and lighter than other materials that we had already tried, like glass beads, sand, etc. So this new morphing concept allows to create a morphing wing that it doesn't have any discontinuity. So it is expected to increase the aerodynamic performance and reduce the noise, and also has the ability to switch stiffness for different flying conditions because we require to sustain aerodynamic loads for different flying scenarios. It's also important to mention that we need to understand the flexural properties of granular jamming. So for doing that, we tested in four-point bending and using a test frame machine and a video gauge system. With that and with digital technique, digital image correlation techniques, we can fulfill the displacement and strains along this device. That will allow us to understand the global mechanical behavior of this device in bending. So you can see in the left pictures the SwitchBAC concept and how it is connected to a vacuum pump. And in the middle pictures, we test this new device using a test frame machine for different loading conditions. The graph shows the load displacement curves for different vacuum levels. So as we increase the vacuum level, there is an increase of stiffness. For this specific device, we can switch the stiffness more than 3 times higher of what it is. For future work, what we want to do is to put this new morphing device, put it in a small fixed wing aircraft or a drone and fly it. So it is expected to switch stiffness for different flying conditions, increase the aerodynamic performance, and reduce the noise. I would like to thank EPSRC and Saber for the funding. And also I want to acknowledge Aeroaxis Lab Support, Marco Longana, Conacyt, and all my friends from the Access Department. Without you, all of this would not be possible. So thank you.